after becoming Prime Minister of India, Mr. Narendra Modi, Honorable Prime Minister of India, started connecting with people and adopting various top-notch technologies like 3D versions and so many things, multiple ways to connect with the people. Man Ki Baat is one such initiative by the Prime Minister of India, where he is trying to connect with the people, re-establish and reduce the gap. He's one of the most powerful communication strategies to connect with the people of the nation. And through that program, he used to raise appeal, he used to convince people, he seeks support and he extends support to build up New India. And very recently, his Man Ki Baat speech was compiled into the book form, and the book was released in Maharashtra. Needless to say that he was able to revive an outdated communication media that has been very prominent in 20th century. That is radio. And his radio talks is receiving in many walks of life by people who are dominantly supporting him, but at the same time his talks are criticized by the people, termed as monologue, and it has been critiqued by them that PM Modi is using Man Ki Baat as his monologue. In between this mixed sphere of the talk, I would like to reconnect with some of the youth of the nation who are fairly mixed with their opinion, but what do they feel about that? We have with us BTech student, engineering pursuant, Miss Manisha Sachdeva. What is your opinion about PM's Man Ki Baat program?
Hello everyone. I want to say that through a radio show Man Ki Baat, he is trying to reconnect with the people of villages and those common people who listen to radio rather than television shows, the farmers of the villages. So basically he's trying to reconnect with the common people. Thank you.
Through his talks, he used to inspire people, he used to share opinion, and at the same time he used to appeal them. How do we look at this various versions of Man Ki Baat? Sometime in his enthusiastic venture, he keeps appealing. Sometime he shared new opinion, new ideas, and he keep inspiring people for that. Sometime he raise a slogan, and sometime he sloganize like Sankalp to Siddhi, and he also appeal with the people that the need for today is to do, not to do or die, but to resolve together, come together for reducing communication gap, and perseverance of the people will bring hope to the New India. For this, his appeal to New India, He is talking up, he is appealing you to work tirelessly, plan and then think. Where in his most recent version, he talked of taking oath for Sankalp Parva, or the day of resolve for making India a new India by 2022. So this way, he's tireless working and in his appeal for constructing nation building and adding everybody, inviting everybody to be the part of new India. And this way, he many a times keep appealing with the people. GST has been promoted by the country as the and under his leadership as the festival of independence, and they tried to people try to look at as the economic independence of India. Many countries adopted GSTs, and under that banner they tried to repeal their multiple layers of taxes. And this tax reform, whether when it is successful, it promises new India and even cost control. And then at the same time, he talk of that whether how vigorously agencies are helping, Indian Army is helping flood victims, and so on and so forth. Let us have a discussion on the toughest blame on his monkey bar. While talking on the blame, people used to talk that his monkey bar is monologue. What is monologue? Monologue is one-way communication, and when a person delivers a long speech without any hindrance of the other person, so that becomes monologue. And here people are terming his monkey bath as monologue, and we feel that this is not monologue. As Devendra Fadnavis rightly said, Devendra Fadnavis is the CM of Maharashtra, and he said at the release of the book version of his Man Ki Baat, all editions, all sanskaranas of Man Ki Baat released in the compiled in the book form, and it was released in Maharashtra, where governor and CM both addressed, and in that very address, Devendra Fadnavis raised a very nice quote. He used a very nice quotation that this is not the monologue. Rather, this could be termed as Dil Se Dil Ki Baat. And this way, Prime Minister is not only sharing his thought, rather he is compiling opinion of the people to whom he is going to talk. He is touching upon the life of performance of the women team, exceptional performances of other achievers, their achievement. He is saluting, and at the same time he is promoting non-performing sectors to perform exceptionally, and that appeal can turn the civilization into a different way, and the path can lead the path of progress. That path of progress has always been his opinion sharing and his dream. See, making an India of dream and leading a country of 1.3 billion nation is really a tough job. It's a Herculean task. But how to lead them? How to connect with the people? Even today, most of the Indian people, people used to tell that India is divided into two parts, India and Bharat. Bharat lives in villages and India lives in cities. That division of urban and rural India, in that adopting the technology that modern India is terming communication technology, that modern India has termed a few years back as outdated, that is radios, and adopting that and trying to connect with those who could never be connected otherwise is a real communication strategy. This communication technique, adopting that, Prime Minister was able to shrink the gap, reduce the gap, and try to reach to unreachable, connect with unconnectable, and ultimately he was able to establish a dialogue between himself and his countrymen. Thus, Man Ki Baat becomes Dil Se Dil Ki Baat, and it becomes somewhat between the people, among us the people of India, by the People's Prime Minister. In his very recent talk, he also talked that GST is more than just a tax. Rather, it ushers in a new culture. And then while terming GST as a new culture, how a culture can be promoted? Very recently an article came that an organization's culture is its heart and soul, and its culture must be nurtured to nourish and cherish the heritage. For that purpose, the commitment of the people is required. And what we feel that by adopting this Man Ki Baat, he was truly able to reach out to the people who are in villages and leading a deprived life. His appeal for a dream to make a promise in 2017 August to make it a real of a year of resolve, he is trying to make countrymen resolve for development that he wish to offer by the year 2022, that is going to be the 75th year of Indian independence. That's it. And certainly he was able to break the boundaries of monologue by adopting one of the oldest traditional communication media, where in his final talk of July end, his appeal to uproot terror, uproot poverty, and uproot casteism and communalism, and rather appeal to make this 1.3 billion nation to billions paradise has really been a nice initiative.